Hi, I'm Bob from Bob's Burgers. How about that show Archer? You watch that show Archer? Here's that guy, Archer. Hi, I'm Archer from that show Archer. Now, what if those guys met? Hey, Archer, it's Bob. Hey, Bob, it's Archer.
You could do bad stand-up. That's really popular.
I asked Peter what he got on his SATs. He said mayonnaise.
Good job.
Shut up. Odin doesn't beat Sterling Archer. Only Sterling Archer beats.
Did you want to finish that thought?
Did you want to finish shutting your big fat negative wordsy mouth? Also, because I'm not an ant, Lana, I happen to see the big picture.
Oh, really? Well, then where's Kasparov? Okay, that was a fluke.
Yeah, a fluke of nature, because I happen to have perfect situational awareness, Lana.
Archer.
Which cannot be taught, by the way.
Archer.
Like a poet's
Archer.
Mind for
Archer.
To make the perfect word.
Archer!
God damn it! I'm relatively...
You are the coolest guy I have ever met.
Yeah. Well, I'm not Yoda. Okay, I'm Yoda.
Greetings, shitheads.
Have you guys ever seen Jim Henson's Labyrinth?
No. Have you ever seen the Channel 5 news?
No.
I don't think we have much in common.
Oh, dear. What's going on?
Bow down, you buffoons! That's the master!
Ah, it's about damn time!
Hello. You all know me. I live in many of your closets. And guess what? You dinks have forced me out of the closet.
You go, girl!
Solidarity, my brother!
My master, why have you chosen the form of Father Christmas?
Oh, I'm sorry. Should I have chosen the Halloween ferret? Not a lot of options here, pal.
You're not Santa! You are the devil! How dare you!
Red Mantle, you know better than bringing a normal here. Even if he is wearing black. That's not cool.
I didn't want to miss the party.
You know what? The party's over, okay? I just had to put hundreds of zombies back in the ground. You've lost the true meaning of Christmas. This is the day that a baby was born to remind us that we shouldn't raise an army of dead guys just because we can.
I used to be a soda pop guy. Then I switched to the bottle. Now I don't leave my couch and I've seen every movie ever. You name a movie, I've seen it.
For the moment, there's no way out.
No Way Out. Great film. Sean Young, naked in the limo.
Well, maybe the storm will let up soon.
I don't know. It's a hard rain.
Christian Slater, Morgan Freeman.
We just want the money.
We should have known this weather was coming. There's been 3 days of thunder.
Tom Cruise, race cars. Those are my bedsheets. Oh, Selma Blair and Sarah Michelle Gellar make out. It's pretty hot. 47 minutes, 16 seconds in.
Tatiana, what are you doing here?
I was just sitting here thinking how glad I am that I left you for the Outrider. And how he does that thing you used to do with your mouth, but better, because he can hold his breath longer.
Oh, it is you, my master.
Duh, Orpheus. But I'm serious, hold on. This other head likes to clean my genitals with his mouth. I know it sounds weird. I let him do it, because it feels great. Oh, yeah. The problem is I can taste it. So, I taste my own genitals in my mouth. It's a conundrum.
Master, what bearing does this...
Hey, will you let me enjoy this? Damn, don't you know how good this feels? Oh, no, wait. I'm sorry. Your wife left you because you don't know how good this feels.
My wife left me because of the persistent advances of a younger man.
No, she left you because you spent most of your time working.
Well, yes. I was saving the world from a secret peril.
Whoop-dee-doo. And your precious free time was spent like Mr. Rogers in a cape. She left you because you're a wussy.
Now, what's all this crybaby crap about? Aren't you used to the Outrider making you look like a schnook by now?
He came out of a portal to the second world. I have been training my whole life just to perceive that there is a second world, and he can move between them. Tell me, master, how can this be?
The love of a good woman can do wonders, Orpheus. I mean, look at me. These are natural sea cups. Aren't they beautiful? I mean, you could bounce a penis off these.
I doubt my ex-wife's breasts are the answer.
It doesn't stop there. I'm sitting on what is easily the ass of a teenager. I mean, what does she do, Pilates or something? You could rest a coffee mug on it.
Really? She's almost 40 by now.
Well, you tell it to the hiney, Orpheus, because it still thinks it's 1992.
But, master, the Outrider was my student. He was a petulant layabout. There is no way he could achieve this ability.
Well, he did. Maybe he got super good at meditating.
Meditate perfectly.
Up, Donaghy, and meditate!
Congratulations, Jack. You have attained... Shut up, I don't have time for this. Give me my inspiration. My God, you're good at meditating. The answer you seek has been there all along. It's right behind you. Behind you. Behind you. Behind you.
I don't need an echo. I heard you. Meditation over!
Sitting in the back of the brain is the superior being.
is, I mean, when I say a superior being, like every single thing about this particular reality that they're saying is the high, the holy, the most top, the big boy, the main thing, you know, what's on fleek, is sitting in the back of the brain in each human being, proving that they actually have a very powerful entity within them, that they are powerful entities, and that what you're looking at in the physical reality is the projected side, like you literally sending out a hologram of yourself into another space and it not even doing that great of a justice in projecting exactly what you truly are, because you forgot that you're even doing this. It's time. Like all this play going on, all this lying, these weapons and scaring folks and eating the seeds and hurting the children, it's a wrap. I told you. Don't, when I say, hey, I can't say I told you so, whatever those, man, 10 years, Doc. 10 years looking for the secret. You know how funny it feels? Like I always said, hey, sometimes we can't see the secret because it's like right too close to our face. You know, it's like when you're holding, like you write a number on your hand, you hold your hand up to your face, you can't see the number. If you write on your eye, you can't see it. What if it's behind you? Whoa, that means you would literally every single day subconsciously step forward, never realizing it was taking you a step back. Wow, man, if you didn't know that, it's like, what I mean is that if you're constantly going to look for something that's actually behind you, you just need to turn around. Like, think about all of our lives, you know, what our youth was like and when we had vigor and everything was pure and it was true. Meaning that everything is Santa Claus. Really? Yeah, true. Oh shit, what is he doing? He's in the North Pole. He's got gifts. He's got, oh shit, you know, that's a light idea. I'm talking about the massive everything that we believed when we were young in existence of what we were capable of doing and who we were. It's now here. And it's here at a perfect time, because if you look at what's going on in reality, for me personally, the last 3 days has been intense. Intense. I just found out 80% of the conscious community is being influenced not only by the CIA, but at least 40% of them know that they are, and conceding to a plan to go into some kind of dystopian future where it's like the movie Time, where everybody is in the slums in the ghettos of the fourth world while the elite are in their automated systems, you know, sucking up all the medications and all of what the trees taught and all of what nature taught and all that. And they're going to live in this space and let nature overrun the rest of humanity. And then you got people in the conscious community under the guise of the Lima actually perpetrating this, dealing even with darker entities that they can't even control, that they were playing around with over there, messing around in Kandy or in India, and in places where, you know, the Tantra, you know, the Yantra, the machines, you know, playing around with the machines and the magical cubes and moving the numbers around wrong to see if you can try something, and then bam, now you're a slave, letting go of the body. See, this is what it's really about. They let go of the body. That's why I say, hey, let go and tune out. Okay? Let go and tune out. This is the whole thing that they teach. You know, you're going to take this substance and you're just going to let everything go and you're going to fly out there. And then these people have no, they don't even have moral bearing. So what do you think they find way out there if even what they're looking for is right behind them? Huh? They met something. And that's what it sounds like. It's dead. It has no energy. Lost. Gone. And it is moving through them. And now what comes is the resolution to that. The solution for that. However that looks. So get ready. Get ready. And I told you, I just left a message day before yesterday. I said, listen, all of that stuff that's going on out there now that I know so many people are affiliating and think they're going to ride off, you were sold a lie.
You know, I don't want to speak to anybody directly because some people are like, man, what are you talking about? But you'll know now, just like Star Wars, they shoot that shit in the, from they give you the last one, and then they bring you down all the way to the first one. So that's how this is going to work. You're going to hear about some stuff, then you're going to be able to go back to the corner and say, oh, okay, that's what he was talking about. Those are the people that he was talking about. And now, why? Why does it have to happen? Well, darkness must come to the light. Like, hey, the reality is in all of this that we get to a higher stage. The moment that everybody just comes out clean with whatever they're involved in and whatever they've been doing. I think everybody in this has been told for at least this last 10 years, get your stuff together. If you're out there, you're trying to teach people, you're trying to, you know, say you're helping people. If you're not really about that, you know there could be repercussions. And now people are like, oh man, you know what? I don't think there is any repercussions because after all, why would they be launching bombs and killing children and all that kind of stuff? There was really repercussion. So shoot, I'm just going to, you know, betray quite a few. I'm just going to betray some people. I'm really doing good for them. I'm really doing good, but I got my thing that I'm doing on the side because who cares, you know, and then I'm going to get along with this other group. Oh, you guys are doing some darkness? Oh man, I guess. What's the philosophy here? Oh, we're the controllers. We're the leaders. We're the supreme beings. We found out that we were really all in the bottom of the earth and that we were really supposed to be the master race over every single creature and that we are supposed to subdue the earth. And then that the earth was going to work for us. We were going to be its leaders and rulers and they were going to be our slaves and blah, 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 blah. Oh, really? Oh, really? What are you saying? You're saying I can get in on that plan too?
Yes, yes. You can get on this plan. All I need you to do is give me everything that you have.
What do you mean? Oh, your soul, and your integrity, and your trust. And everything that we tell you to do, you do. No matter what it is, you do it. Okay, and for this, what do I get?
Fame, fortune, power, all that kind of stuff, whatever.
Oh, I will do it. And that is who I'm coming for. That decision you made, it's cost. It's cost a lot of us. On the backs of my people, this cost blood, sweat, legacy, nobility. And now you have to pay. That is the only way this balances out. You see? It's all about the financing. And the prophets and the prophecy and watching stars. You see? Like this is so big, most of the childlike human beings sitting in even old bodies don't even know what's going on. Some are like, man, this is wild. I don't know if I should just take this as an abstract form of art, like Basquiat. This is like some new shit, right? Reacting. So now you get to see the action. And all of this that I said right now, just remember, when you really are looking for what it takes to actually take it to the next stage, it's right behind you. All you need to do is turn around and face it. Focus and balance vibrations.
Chapter 1 blows open. Subscribe to Secret Energy TV or this channel for future show notifications. Bonus.
Either be ensouled or maintain your soul.
I don't know.
Impossible.
Well, Orpheus, it happened. Hey, are you looking at my dress? See anything you miss?
Oh, no. I don't miss her astounding beauty daily.
Orpheus, you can't take being bested. You know, you really thought that you could just build a portal with lawn furniture and go kick his ass?
Well, yes. Yes, I did. If that insect could do it.
Okay, well, go to it, champ. Go find a portal and beat him up. Solve. Just stop whining. You give me a huge headache. Can you rub my temples?
Must I?
Okay, do you have an aspirin then?
I don't take them.
What about ibuprofen?
Sorry.
What about acetaminophen?
Nope.
Tylenol PM?
No.
What about ecstasy?
Nothing.
It's ear-splitting, Orpheus. Maybe I have a brain tumor. Seriously, you don't know any other way to cure my headache?
I can't really think of one.
Oh, wait, I have one. Why don't you leave me alone so I can jump rope naked in front of a mirror in your ex-wife's body?
Right on the nose! Oh! You have no idea how much that stinks.
Master?
Yes?
I have need of your counsel.
Oh! Orpheus, you're gonna love this. Check me out. Huh? I'm Catherine the Great's horse to teach you a lesson about biting off more than you can chew. My partially lovely assistant, Miss Manyface, will be playing the part of Catherine.
Hi.
Hey, enough with the chatter. Get under there. Don't wince.
Master, far be it from me to question the relevance of your symbolism, but I'm fairly certain the whole horse thing was an urban legend.
Wow.
That's normal, right?
I think he's lost a lot of blood. Sir, is this all your blood? Because it's a lot of blood.
It's okay. Dr. Jesus is here. You're wound up like a spring, my son. Let me anoint you.
Oh, yeah, that's great. Right there. Ow! Ow! Hey, that's a little rough. Oh, my God! Oh, Lord God, my Savior. I don't understand the symbolism.
I'm not touching that thing. Whoa! You open it.
Here. Let's just let him rest. Well, would you look at that?
Oh, there we go.
God helps those who help themselves.
Yay, Jesus!
Evangelicals.
You have an anointed weekend, okay?
Yeah. Irene Portfleep just called. He wants you to pose for him. Oh, come on. Beloved illustrator of gnomes? Jesus, read a coffee table book.
Brain! Push on his brain!
Whoa!
Wow!
Viva Italia!
Who ordered Olive Garden?
Hey guys, I'm dumb. What the hell?
I know. Manna from heaven.
More like guts from hell.
What's going on, man? You pregnant?
Now, my wife watched that food documentary. And you should never ask that unless you're sure, by the way.
Welcome to the Fat Club, Brendan.
No.
Yes. You and me. Fat Club members.
No.
Yep.
No.
Nothing wrong with it. In fact, you should be proud of your size.
No.
And I'll tell you, the first way of dealing with your fat is admitting it. Now say it, fatso.
No, you say it.
All right, you're fat. You're getting fatter. It's amazing. I love it.
Okay. So I'm fat. Big deal.
Well, you know what? You passed the first step, Brendan. Now, the next question you have to ask yourself is, how does being fat work for me? Well?
I don't know.
Well, it makes you funnier. Everybody loves a fat guy. They're funny.
I would have to get really fat, wouldn't I, to get really funny, right?
No. Sometimes you just have to be a little dumpy, which is what I would call you right now.
I'm dumpy.
Yeah, it's phase one.
Okay.
There's about 8 phases. It starts from dumpy, then it goes to frumpy, then it goes to fat.
Right.
6 phases of fat. I don't know. I'm not a scientist. I'm just saying. You get fatter and fatter. That's what happens. You start the cycle, and then you don't stop.
Mm-hmm. Isn't it, like, totally unhealthy?
So? All right, how about this, Brendan?
Yeah.
Some girls like fat guys because their fathers were fat, right?
Mm.
So you play on that. It's the fat father syndrome. It's the FFS.
Fat father syndrome.
Yeah. Girls have fat fathers, all right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you're fat, you remind girls of their father.
Is anyone in here?
Hi, Sugar Dumpling. I was just vacuuming, and after this, I'm going to watch TV and then cry myself to sleep. I don't know, I might wake you up in the middle of the night and threaten to kill myself if you leave me again. So, how's work?
What is this? Who are you?
Baby doll, it's me, your loyal husband, Dean Venture. I'm your future. Isn't this great? Oh, that's our baby, Rusty Jr. Well, if you can call it a baby, it's got like a leg growing out of what would be a head on a regular baby. And if you squeeze him, poop comes out of his eyes and a little bit under his fingernails.
I just walked into a closet. What is going on?
Oh, we had a deformed kid because my gene pool is more of like a gene septic tank. Yeah, I was cloned so much I can only make monster babies.
Wait. Dean was cloned?
Dean was cloned, Hank was cloned, and you've been here like 10 times before this. Surprise! Somebody's been getting her memory wiped.
No place for cursing in a civilized society, all right?
Yeah.
I'm telling you this because I'm a coach.
Yeah, I know.
And you're just a kid.
Yeah.
You can't go around cursing now.
Yeah.
It will end up ruining you when you get older.
Right. But do you think...
What the f*** was that, ref? You f***ed up head?
Wow.
Unless, Brendan.
Yeah, yeah.
Unless you know how to do it right.
What do you do?
Obviously.
Yeah, my ears are still ringing.
Yeah, it's called creative use of words.
Right.
It's like poetry.
Yeah.
Like Robert Frost.
Right.
Stopping by the woods.
Right.
On a snowy f***ing evening.
Right.
That kind of f***.
That's good stuff.
But it's my poetry.
Right.
It's the everyday man's poetry.
I only know that I know nothing.
Way to quote something I said like a year ago.
I am a rube. I have been fooling myself my whole life.
Makes you feel pretty small, huh?
We are nothing.
Orpheus, you are my best and brightest pupil, even if you do taste a little salty. You're ready, Orpheus. Now get the hell out of this closet and go win that incredibly gay contest! Go!
Here's a piece of advice, Brendan. There's no such thing as psychology. It's all made up crap.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They're all con men. Oh. All of them. Even the women.
Well.
Just remember that when they're telling you how screwed up you are.
Okay.
And let me tell you something else. Astronomy is BS, too.
Really?
Yeah, all that star crap is ridiculous.
But there are stars.
Whatever, Brendan.
Okay. Will you ever go to a therapist?
Well, yeah, sometimes you gotta do certain things to re-enter society, all right?
I guess I've got some issues.
Well, like what? I'll fix them.
Well, I guess I'm slightly frustrated about my father remarrying, you know, this...
That's a load of crap, Brendan.
Yeah, well...
But come on. That's psychobabble.
What?
Don't fall prey to it, Brendan.
Okay, what does that mean, though?
So what were you saying?
All right, now, let's go over what we've learned. Naked chicks, best?
Rebecca De Mornay in Risky Business.
Good.
Oh, Charleston Chew. Good choice. You know about putting them in the freezer?
Yeah, I know about the freezer. There's nothing you can teach me, thank you.
Look, I make burgers, but I also do this little chalkboard with the burgers of the day. I think they are hilarious. They probably aren't.
They're okay.
They're bad, but that's okay because they make me laugh. I do it for me, and you're a really good accountant, right? I hope.
I'm pretty good.
So just keep on doing that. Keep on accounting, but also make your jokes because you like them, okay? But work on them more.
Whoa, okay, look. If you'd be willing to forget this whole thing happened, I'll give you this gas card.
Unlimited free gas for a year? Just because I threatened to sue you?
Well, that, and you're not the worst-looking guy who's ever come in here.
That's what I wanted to hear.
The other thing, Brendan, is cheating is
right.
Just another way of being prepared.
Okay.
Basically, memorizing something is cheating.
Right.
You knew the answer before the test was given.
Right.
And so by taking the test and saying that you learned that stuff...
It's cheating.
You're already cheating.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, I'm discovering all this, too, as I say it.
I can read it just like everybody else. And the charade continues. Looks like I'm all alone. Well, hey, that's all right. I watch a lot of movies. I can just use my imagination.
Stop cooking. I figured it all out. The Italian inhabited your bodies to cook its grandmother's old recipe for human disaster.
What?
Don't you see? The RV is a breeding ground for the master race of Noodlezoids.
Oh, come on.
Noodlezoid my ass.
If you want attention, just say so. Just say, hey, I need a hug. Okay?
You're right. That's crazy. I have been talking to a noodle for a year.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, hey, Orpheus! You missed all the fun. Your idiot friends had the great idea to reanimate a graveyard. Is that neat?
Not neat! There are children walking the streets! I'm so disappointed in all of you!
Ooh, I smell a lecture. Okay, take it easy on them. They didn't know that Daddy keeps bullets in his gun.
I will, my master.
You're my best pupil and all that crap.
Thank you, my master.
Yeah. Merry Christmas to all and to all a good night. Ho, ho, ho.
All right, let's go out and enjoy this beautiful day while we sun our new beards.
Yeah!
No!
Play us out with the taxophone.
Bloody Mary, full of vodka, blessed are you among cocktails. Pray for me now, and at the hour of my death, which I hope is soon. Amen.
You'll forget all this ever happened.
Honestly, even if you go there and you don't have a great time, at least you know that I will click like on all your photos.
Jesus Christ, Nancy.